I bought a trailer full of oak to make baseboards out of. The first thing I need to do is make sure I have a straight edge on all of them on my jointer. Some of the boards were too long for my jointer, but I still managed to get them straightened out. Now I need to rip those boards all to widths of my baseboards, and for that I figured it would be useful to have some sort of a power feeder, so I mounted this roller skate wheel on a shaft on a drill, and I jigged this thing up here, and then another thing here to press down on it, and hopefully that will work as a power feeder. Now testing it with an actual cut. My power feeder doesn't quite work perfectly. It's more of a power assisted hold down, but that it makes life a lot easier already. Also, the way I had it jigged up, I couldn't quite use it on the widest boards I had, but that's okay, there's only a few of those. The boards were rough sawn and varied quite a lot in thickness, so the next step was to plane them all repeatedly. I'm making sure the planer always has at least one board going through it so I can avoid the snipe at the start and end of a board.
Well, I knew these dryer hoses are not meant for that sort of thing. And planing quite this much material, it just kind of put a hole in it. But I will cut this part off and I'll try it again, see if it falls again. Maybe if I put another straight piece here, the shavings won't be flying quite so fast anymore and it's not going to destroy the hose as quickly.
And with that change made, the flimsy dryer hose held up just fine for the rest of the planing. Now, some of those boards were not new and had some screw holes to fill in, so here I'm making some plugs to fill those with. Before making the final pass through the thickness planer, I went through all the boards to make sure I had at least one good side, and also figure out which side is going to get the final planing pass.
Here's what the plugs look like. Most of them look pretty good. It's full to about here now. I should empty that.
One of the rare pieces of useful advice I've gotten out of a YouTube comment is to use magnets to hold the bag up while putting it back on.
I figure this sort of profile would look nice on the baseboards, and I can cut that with a raised panel router bit on this improvised router table. But before I cut these, I figure it would help to cut away much of this material on the table saw. I have a thin curve ripping blade in here, and I've got that tilted to take away much of the excess material. And to help me feed it through, I improved my improvised feeder gadget, and now it even has a knob for adjusting how much downward pressure I've got. Still powered with a drill, still using a roller skate wheel. Wow, that actually works. I got my power feeder jigged up on the router table, plus two little roller skate bearings to help press the wood against the fence. So let's see how that goes. So I need some custom hose flange to fit on here, and if I had a 3D printer, I could design that and print that out and spend a day at it. Fortunately, I don't have a 3D printer, so I just used a piece of 4x4 beam, cut a hole in it with a bandsaw, and then cut these two sides flat to fit up against the router like this. I had to go from a 3-inch to a 4-inch, so I just use a piece of towel as a hose adapter, because this is going into my big dust collector. Running now. Plenty of suction. The problem with this drill is if you hold the trigger steady for about 5 minutes, eventually it stops and then you have to let go of the trigger and restart it. Looks like I'm clearing the dust quite successfully. I'm drawing about 700 watts worth of router, but it's also running at its lowest speed of 10,000 RPM, so I really shouldn't push it. I don't want to burn out this router.
With so much air getting sucked through the router, it wasn't even getting warm to the touch.
Holy crap, that is loud! Now I think what would be nice is to add just a little bit of a roundover right here, and normally I just do that with a hand plane. But with quite that much material, I think I'll set up to cut that with a router.
And now making such a small cut, I was able to bump up the RPM and the feed rate by a lot.
Here's a roundover I just added, and to make sure the top edge stays flat against the wall even if it's uneven, I'm adding a hollow cove cut on the back, and I'm doing that on the table saw, going sideways across the blade and once again with a power feeder. I set the blade at a 45 degree angle, so as the wood comes in like this, the top of the teeth do the cutting instead of the sides, because that works so much better. It's at times like this it becomes clear to me that what I've got here is not professional grade equipment. I just took the belt off of here because once a year the nut on the back of this pulley becomes loose and I need to tighten it. Oh yeah, and my mini dust collector on here, that wasn't really meant for production work either, so I had to clean it out a few times during this run. Just to put it into perspective, that cove cut that I did with two side-by-side passes, that filled two buckets full of sawdust. And just cutting the bevel off, here's the offcuts from that, and ripping the pieces to width, here's the offcuts from that. I'm very happy with how consistent these all came out, and I think that has a lot to do with using a power feeder, and I think I'll make a video about that next.